Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm rendering exposition of Romans, and they are quite instructive, you know. If you can, are a person of spirit, but the Jewish people, Messianic Jews, when they occupied the church and bring in their Jewish leaven, which is the Old Testament, rotten Old Testament, they corrupted the New Testament as well, so making the confusing the people. So the men of letters who go by the written word, they cannot understand gospel. They have no gospel for them. Gospel is for people of spirit, of discerning intellect, who can understand or who can pinpoint the corruptions. Here it is corruption here, because the gospel comes from your heart. When you have Christ in your heart, this is the temple of God. The priest of temple of God is royal priest called Christ. Our Father is royal because he gives everything free. He gives gift. He doesn't charge you. So anybody, like kingdom, you know, the kingdom of God, people sometimes say it is wrong, because the kingdom belongs to the kings, and kings, they charge taxes, money from the people. They don't give anything free. But our is royal kingdom of God. This is the royal kingdom of God, and we give it, we receive it free, we give it free. And these hireling dog-collared people, they have nothing to do with God. They are working, they are priest, working for Yahweh. They are hireling, they are worse than the rabbis. So be careful of them. So, verse Romans 10, verse 14 onward. How then will they call on him in whom they have not believed? That means God. Rabbi is the intermediary between man and Yahweh. Thus, rabbis are priests for men, ordained by men. They are Levite tribe, you know, ordained by men, with whom their praises rest. Whilst in God, we are the royal priests, ordained not by men, but by our royal Father. We glorify our Father in honor of Christ Jesus by preaching gospel, and our sport is our Father. Me and my Father are one, because he lives in my temple, in the temple of God. Yahweh cannot be believed in our heart, as he is not real, but he is written in the scriptures as the creator of male and female, and as such, gods are of a mythological nature and are the demiurge god. That's why they are called demiurge god. They are shadow to the real God, but not real. Demiurge gods of God of nature called Brahma. So their rabbis even kept Yahweh, the demiurge god of nature Brahma, called Khuda in Arabic, alienated from them. Then how will they will be aware of living God that is within us if they think still God is in heaven, as they say in prayer? So they don't know that God is inside us, Emmanuel. Houses of the demiurge gods are brick built, made by human hands, whereas the temple of God, our supernatural Father, has been built by the subservient demiurge god, Yahweh of nature at large, nature at large. All they see with your true naked eye is the creation of Yahweh. You can see how perfect it is. Minute insect has everything, you know, stomach, heart, everything at large. A perfect builder. So, you know, this circumcision, if it was necessary, you know, then our Father Yahweh would have got it done when we were born. Man doesn't need to interfere with his nature, but it is a tribal mark by the man, by the tribal fathers. So this is a tribal mark by Abraham with his son Isaac, and not with the Ishmael, Gentiles. I met a university professor in Oxford and asked him about the circumcision. He said, oh, both Ishmael and Isaac, they were both circumcised by Abraham. I was so surprised, you know. This is what the knowledge they have. They want to make Jews through circumcision. Like the Mohammedan, they have circumcisions too. So they want to increase the number of the Jews through circumcision and saying, hey, look, they are coming, they are all obeying the Moses law and all that nonsense. So this tribal mark is between Abraham and Isaac and his seed. His seed are those who are born of the semen of Isaac and his people and his tribal people. Not born of a woman, cannot be a son of Abraham. Woman has no seed. And how are they to believe in him of whom they have never heard? Because the rabbi kept them, you know, if they mention the name of God, they won't let them speak full name. They will miss a letter, you know. Yeah, they GD they write instead of God. Even today, you know. So they are so much frightened by the rabbi not to write the name, but you can bloody cheat people, fleece them, and kill them. That is allowed, but you are not allowed to mention the name of God. This is a nonsense. Rabbi did not let them know the demiurge God of nature, Yahweh, never mind our real father, then how would they know our supernatural father God if they don't know the natural father called Parbrahm, Elohim or Allah, in the same name, you know, of the supernatural father? And how are they to hear without someone preaching gospel? And how are they to preach gospel unless they are predestined or sent by our Father? So gospel is known by when you preach gospel, then people are seeking, you know. So when you preach gospel, you explain to him everything in detail. And any doubts he has in his heart, you clarify it. So they should be crystal clear. So the royal priests, they don't go read the Bible. Bible are letters. They can't have spirit. Spirit comes from our Christ, our Father, who is inside me, Emmanuel. So without Father, you cannot preach gospel. Because Father provides the spirit, that is Christ, make it sit in your heart and you open your mouth and preach. As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the good news, gospel. That means people, you know, that is what Abraham, he would have loved to see Christ Jesus and to hear his word. But these Jews are unfaithful to Abraham and unfaithful to Yahweh, and no wonder they hated him, you know. That is why Christ Jesus said, and called, while he was sitting in the temple, he called the Jews that your forefathers are devil. When he said that, they said, are you a Samaritan that you are calling our forefathers devils? Then they took stones to hit him, you know, but he dodged, and because no stone could hurt him unless he himself present to them, you know. So not a single hair came off his head until he himself presented as the Lamb of God after 4 years of preaching. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah says, Father is God and Lord is Yahweh. You know, they mix up. Our Father is God and Lord is Yahweh, you know. He is the one they get alienated and frightened. Children, you know, who has believed what he has heard from us? So faith in God comes from hearing, and hearing through the mouth of Christ. Mouth of Christ. But you need ears free of wax to hear his word. This is the, Jesus said, you know, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Now when these men of letters, you know, 5,000, to whom he had fed well, when they heard him say this thing, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus, he said, shall we chop him small and eat him? They didn't understand that in the beginning was the word. Word can't speak or live among us. It need flesh, which was named Jesus. So when Jesus speaks, it is the word of mouth, word of God coming from his mouth. And you have to have ears to hear it. Ear is the stomach. Sorry, ear is the mouth. Ear is the mouth. You take it, eat it with your mouth, understand it, take it to your heart and digest it and bring it from your mouth after digesting. And that is called drinking the blood of Christ. The other one, bread we eat this way, it comes from the other end. We don't want to touch it. But here it's opposite. We eat it with this ear. It doesn't go to the other side, but comes on the heart. From heart it comes. It is abstract. It's not solid. It is spirit. But you need ears free of wax. Wax is created when you don't use the ears. It will develop wax. So people who depend upon letters, dead letters of the books, as in the university professors, if you ask them simple questions, they will start searching books, you know, to find the answer. But they have no heart to explain the answer, you know. They just quote the book, dead letters, they will quote. That is it. You like it or not, up to you. No understanding. That is why I asked these university people, who created Adam and Eve? They have no idea. Because the God is spirit. What is born of spirit is spirit, not flesh. So Yahweh is God of the flesh. So Yahweh created Adam and Eve and not our Father God. But they have no idea because they think there's only one God. And they say it has two natures and all that, you know, nonsense. How can one God has two natures? One God, one nature. Love and serve. And not to frighten and beat people. Letters do not use ears. But they use head, you know. But had to memorize what is said and to reproduce on examination. You can examine people in letters but not in spirit. Examination of spirit is known to the people of spirit. They appreciate. They don't test each other. They company, they go together, you know, where two or three are sitting together in the name of Jesus, he is among us. So we all cooperate. We are not cutting the throat of each other as they do it in the letters. Let the dead bury their dead letters. No freedom in the letters. But I ask, have they not heard? Indeed they have, for their voice has gone out to all the earth, and their words to the ends of the world. But I ask, did Israel not understand? First Moses says, I will make you jealous of those who are not a nation. With a foolish nation, I will make you angry. Now, there you are, you know, Moses, they are putting this jealous and revengeful, bringing in the Old Testament. The chosen people are a nation of priests. And when Moses made them faithful to Abraham and Yahweh, they enjoyed the best fruit of earth, Garden of Eden. And they were ruling their own country as during the time of King David, when the people of Judah tribe were Judah, not Jews. Judah outwardly, you know, and not Jews outwardly. They became Jews outwardly, I think about 150 or 200 years later than King David, when somebody told me, you know, when King David died, then after 200 years, they start, the Jew and Judah became synonymous. So the high priest of this temple, when Jesus was tried, he was Judah tribe, because they were the one who were dominating the temple. They are more clever than the people of Levi tribe. Same applies to India. People of Khatri tribe are more clever than people of those tribes doing the rabbinic services, or we call them Brahman. Kohen and Brahman are same thing. Both are professions. Then Isaiah is so bold as to say, I have been found by those who did not seek me. I have shown myself to those who did not ask for me. But of Israel, he says, all day long I have held out my hands to a disobedient and contrary people. That means those people who are Gentile, you know, they sought all this spiritual knowledge and he gave it to them. So, but to Israel, you know, he came specially to tell them, and they were so disobedient, to no way they listened to him. That is why Jesus lamented that my father sent you prophets and you maltreated them. Some were beaten, some were thrown out, and all that, you know, he mentioned. You have been looked after like hen looking after her little chicken, little baby chicken. So that is how these chosen people are spoiled child, and they have been misbehaving and suffering, and now they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning that should take place around 2018 or 19. What is happening in the world, you see these Shia, Sunni, and all this problem is going to escalate. And Israel is supposed to attack a country making atomic bomb. And then real tribulation, it should be before 2016 they should attack. And when real tribulation start, then the Jews will be rushing to Israel, as they did in 66 AD to Jerusalem when the village people start killing them. So history is going to repeat itself. So we are lucky to be alive and watching the end of the world, and we have a great chance to preach gospel and earn our salvation or present ourselves for the gift of salvation. We can't earn it, you know, it's not a wage. So sorry for the language, you know, sometime, but you understand what I mean. Our Father God blesses you.